Hello everyone, welcome back. It's Chuck Thunder and we're back with another episode of my Let's Play series here on Vineland, New Jersey, the home state series as I call it. We are going to quickly just sell off this small portion of sunflowers. I don't think we are at a time of year where it's worth very much. Let's take a look here. 1,274 at the oil mill. Green sell point south, 1,300. Yeah, we're 1,329. That's where we're at. I don't know if that's the highest price. Oh, that's right. We are using, I say February is going to be the highest price. We are September. No, which is pretty close. We'll just go ahead and sell it. So I don't know if you guys noticed the discrepancy there, but here it says the highest price is $7.95. But as you can see that the current sell price is actually a lot higher. It was 1,300 or so. And that's because I installed a mod that gives us better prices for that. But that does mean, though, that other goods are also expensive. So like we did sunflowers, sunflower oil should be even more. Yeah, still more, you know, still worthwhile for the production. But now I at least have a somewhat profitable venture here. So now I just need to find where that place is. I keep going back and forth here. So sunflowers, where are you? We're gonna go to the grain sell point north. Where are you? Not there, not there. Farm shop north. Grain sell point north. Okay, so we're pretty much already there. We could just cut across the fields because this little tractor is not very powerful and we need to make a little bit of money. Actually, with that being said, maybe we will fill this whole thing up and start selling it off. I don't know that it's going to get much higher because we have yet to see how the prices fluctuate by comparison to what they normally do in base game, but I want to at least go with the assumption that I could make more here. And if I can get enough to get myself a new tractor, that would be wonderful. So let us just get this filled all the way to the tippy top with 8,000 liters. So we're looking at least 8,000 bucks there. And then it's just overestimated. I'm just taking, you know, 1,300 and multiplying it by 8 and ignoring that it's 1,300 and saying 8 and saying 1,000, so we'll get an extra 30% more than 80, so that's more than 8,000, so that'll probably be, and would be 800, another 2,400 bucks, so we'll take it. So let us get ourselves a move on. I could see it in the distance. That's where we're gonna go sell this off. And we'll do this one load at a time until we have enough money to hopefully buy a better tractor. We're gonna keep this tractor, obviously, but we definitely want to get a better tractor for buying better equipment with the next load's money, because that's important. And so all we've done with this tractor so far is we still need to seed those fields. It is just not really time to seed for what I want to seed for, which is sunflowers again, or corn, or anything that could be harvested with that particular header. So we have to wait till at least again March. So we need, maybe we'll spend the money on some way to come do some grass work or something, because we need to make a little bit of extra cash between here and the next season. I mean, we could do some contracts. That's always a possibility, but we have several thousand liters of, yeah, we have 19,000 here, so if we make 8,000 bucks from this, we could at least do this another two more times and then change, so we can get up to like 24,000 bucks and see what we can afford with that. So this should be the proper sell point. Just make sure. Yep. Please sell and make me money. Thank you. looks like it's going to be, there's 8,000 right there. Maybe more than I thought. 10,633. Yeah, that's what I thought. 2,400 bucks roughly. More than 8,000. So yeah. If we make 10,000 bucks per load, we're going to get at least another 10,000. At least another two more times and then some change. So we're going to make 35,000 bucks maybe. So that's pretty sweet. Well, we'll see you back when we're done selling it all. Take a moment and we'll see you later. All right, everybody, we're back and we're selling the, not the last of it, but the third load, full load of our sunflowers. We have now 30,000, and some of you might be doing the math right now and be going, hey, that's not quite exactly 30,000 more than what he started with at the beginning of the last cut, and that's because I spent $3,000 of it already on something in which that I also did off camera prior to this episode. I went and bought a greenhouse, a mid-size, I believe, or a small size, forget which one it is, greenhouse. We did that so that we could begin doing some work with tomatoes, because that is what New Jersey is known for, more than anything, tomatoes. So, a large greenhouse, actually. My cats are meowing. So, yeah, we're going to get some water going to make some tomatoes. Hey, what are you doing? Yeah, my cat knows better than to be messing around. He knows I'm about to come over there and check his actions. Yeah, you behave. I hear you, but you behave. Anyways, so yeah, we're not gonna go and fill this last up, the last 2,000 or so that's sitting in our productions. Just because there's really no reason to three and a half. We're gonna save it for if we need it. Right now we just don't, so we're gonna hold off. Maybe we'll sell it in February and maybe the price will be a little higher. But what we are gonna do is we are gonna drop this and we're gonna go pick up our water tank that I bought as well. And just so we could see here, we have a really cheap tractor, but we can't quite afford the next tier up just yet. We may take a loan to get something better for some of our other work, because if we could do things faster, we could just use the money we need, if we can, to pay it off in time here. So let's go ahead and drop this here and let's go pick up the water tank. And also, what's really frustrating is that the water source is really far away, but it is about halfway down. About halfway. Well, it's the whole way down south here. So we're gonna go fill it up, grab it, fill it up, come back and fill up our greenhouse. And which I don't have downloaded right now is a mod for getting water on our property. So we might do that actually, instead of going all the way down to the water source, because why is there no water available anywhere else in this map? I don't understand. Unless there's a body of water that I'm not aware of. But for right now, we'll at least go get the tank. We'll check out for a moment, go download a quick water source mod, you know, so that we can get our water situation figured out. So we'll see you back when we have the tank hooked up and we're filling up with water and we're dropping it off in our greenhouse. So we'll see you guys then. All right, we're back. Excuse me, I am very phlegmy today. We are going to fill this tank up with water from my free water source, which makes sense that I would have a water source on my own freaking property. So we went and downloaded a quick pack that has water tanks and water sources. There is a daily upkeep of like $5 a day, which I think is fairly reasonable for water that we should have for free. Now it does fill up rather slowly, but that's fair. We're filling up from the hose from our house. It shouldn't be like going to a fire hose. So we're going to fill this all the way up and we're going to put this into our greenhouse, and we'll start the whole greenhouse process of making tomatoes. Okay, we are full. Let's bring it around town. Fill you up. And then once you're done, we will hop out and check the Oop, we are on the roof. And we'll check the production. We will activate. And we could just have it store the tomatoes. We don't need to go anywhere nuts with it. But what does it cost to buy water? $200? Not worth it. Shouldn't have to spend any money. So we'll see how much that 2,000 liters of water produces. Jeez. It should produce... 1 liter should produce 1 liter of tomatoes. So we should get around 2,000 liters of tomatoes. Which, if tomatoes sell well... Let's see what tomatoes will get us. Per thousand. This is per thousand. So we should get around $800 from that free water. So... we'll do this a handful of more times until it is completely full. It might take us a while, but that's what we're going to do. So we'll fill that up. We'll check back in with you once that's full. And then we might just get to planting our fields because it's going to take us some time to get there with making some money. Yeah, we're not ready to plant our fields, actually. We just... did the one thing we could do, which was just cultivate it. Is there any or sort of prep that we can do to the fields in the meantime? Let's see. What the heck are you doing? Stab it! Yeah, be done. Making noise over there. Gotta yell at that kitty. Alright, so what can we do? This needs lime. Oof. And this needs lime. We are not ready to do lime. It's going to take us forever to do lime. We're just not ready for it. Oops. So, yeah, we might do some field prep, but lime will not be one of them, I guess. Unless if we're ready to do all that. Because that's a lot of work. A lot of work to do lime with this tiny tractor. We need to get ourselves a lime spreader. We might as well buy one if we can. Where can we buy a lime spreader? You do lime? No, you don't do lime, but either one of these guys do. This guy does it too, but only in a 3-foot pattern. So yeah, you might as well get this big guy, but I'm afraid he won't be able to do it. We need a bigger tractor. We just 100% need a bigger tractor. Because this little guy can do like around the farm stuff like this. And maybe tow some things back and forth, but it cannot. It cannot do the things we need to do. So, what we're going to do is we're likely going to... we're just going to have to forget the lime thing right now. We need to get these fields planted. Actually, no. We have time to lime the fields. We can't do anything with the fields at all until they're plantable, which isn't even until spring. So, we're just going to make some money in the meantime, hopefully... by doing some contracts. So we'll do contracts and we'll do harvesting of these tomatoes and maybe sell the last of our sunflowers off until we can afford a bigger tractor with bigger tools, and we'll check back in with you when we're at that stage, because we are done trying to take care of these bigger fields with this little tractor. We have so much more stuff that we need to get done. We need a bigger tractor to cultivate this field faster, because that took forever to do this big field. We need a bigger cultivator. We need a bigger planter. Actually, the planter is rough, but not all that important. We need something to do lime with, and something that this tractor can actually hold. Like, we can't use this tractor to do lime. If the lime spreader is only going to do, like, 3 feet wide again. It'll take us forever to do it. So we need a big lime spreader. So we'll check in with you guys when that's all done. And when we've got something better and what we can afford after all that, because there's no reason to keep you guys waiting on me doing this back and forth and literally waiting for the money to come rolling in. So as soon as the money starts flowing in a little bit from the tomato harvests, we'll see if we can afford ourselves a bigger tractor with a bigger spreader. I know for a fact... Stop it. I know for a fact that either one of these can pick up that bigger spreader. I'd like an even bigger tractor if we can get the 150. Where are you? I don't see you. There's our 150. Here's 150. We can get up to the 150 horsepower. That would be great. Yeah, that would be ideal. If we can get up to 150 horsepower, because these are great, but we might just go with you because you're a good all around tractor. We'll see. We'll check in with you guys when we have it all figured out, and we'll see you later. All right, we're back, and we bought ourselves a new toy with the money we've made. We've bought ourselves a nice big, the biggest small tractor that we could afford right now. He's nothing special. He's just got a standard PTO hookup in the back, as well as a three-point hitch, and nothing up front. But he is a big boy. He is a 185 horsepower tractor. Now, that's not really a big boy, but that is big by comparison to what we have been using. Oh, geez, I'm not paying attention to where I'm going. So this, we may not have a lot of use for him right this moment, because he could do everything that the other tractor's doing, and the other tractor could do everything else as of right now. It just does a lot slower. But what this will do for me is this will allow me to then buy better equipment in the future with the money we make from the seasons to buy things up to 185 horsepower that we can then pull, which means we can get a better seeder, a better planter. Actually, we could buy a way better planter probably really soon. We could even get rid of the old tractor, but I really feel like having a little extra tractor to do even some of the small things is going to be beneficial. And what's upcoming after all of this, because I think we've already planted the fields, right? So if we've already planted the fields, then we really have nothing else to do other than to cultivate them later, so that we can get them ready for planting. So we need to get a better cultivator, because that tiny, tiny cultivator is not going to cut it for the long term. So we're going to get this tractor back. We are going to make a little extra money off of our tomato field here that is producing some tomatoes. It's not going to earn us a butt ton of money, but it'll make us something in the winter months when we're not doing much else. One of the things I would like to do is I would like to start working on making silage and straw from fields. So if we can get out of the planter situation and into grains, that would be great, because I'd like to be able to make straw bales and harvest them off the field. But at the very least, I'd like to upgrade some of our base equipment so we can continue what we're doing here, but on just a slightly larger operation. So let's see what we're working with here. So our fields have been fertilized up to 50%. Let's check to see their status. They are need rolling. Nope. They are stubble tillage, so they have not been planted yet. So that is actually, yeah, I forgot. It's been a while since I've started recording a bit, guys, so I apologize. What the heck? That was weird. Anyways, so yeah, we are going to get this field planted when it's time to plant. We don't plant until, we could be doing canola or barley right now, but we just don't have a way of actually harvesting that. We only have a way of harvesting corn or sunflowers. We've been doing sunflowers just because we can harvest them sooner. Plant them sooner and harvest them for longer. So we'll probably continue to do that. And we can do that with our standard tractor and plow planter for right now. But let's see, is there anything that we want to get rid of? I mean, this works for us well. This works for us. I mean, we just used it. I don't know if roller is going to be something I'm going to want to replace at some point, because it will need to be rolled. I just don't really care for this roller. This trailer here, perfect setup. Nothing needed to change about that, because it does multi-purpose things for us. Really would just like to get our butts out of this planter. And, oh, we don't even have, because we sold it. We sold it to make room. So we do need to get a cultivator. That's important. So we went and found ourselves, okay, good. So we do have some smaller cultivators. Here's a up to 8.3 meter. So we could pull this one if we really wanted to. This one requires less horsepower, but is up to 8 meters. This one's just a little bit larger, so we'll probably go for this one since it's also cheaper. and we can pull it with our tractor. So that's probably what we'll end up getting, unless we want to go cheap, save a little bit of money so that we can get a better cedar at some point. Our planter. This is the cheapest planter we have right now, so we can get one that'll plant at nearly 2.7 meters for 4,500, or we can get 5.6 for 8,000. Here we can get 6 meters for 10,000, and our machine can handle any of these, which is good. Our new machine, at least. Our new machine can handle this one at 6 meters. This is 3 meters. Oh, yeah. Can't do any of these, but it could do up to... It could do this one, even. 9 meters. Ooh, my phone's buzzing. Could do 9 meters, but we're not about to afford that. So, we'll probably get to the 6-meter ones here. The planters are especially these for useful crops. Interesting, this one offers direct drilling. Ah, that's what we're going to step up to. Yeah, so we need to get the 12,500 in and stuff. And I don't think we're going to get there from just selling this off. 12,500 is not going to be enough. So we really are somewhat counting on our ability to sell off this for, well, that's something. That's not much of anything. It's all of 2,000 bucks altogether. Yeah, we're not about to get rid of our tractor either, just for that. We might... No, we're not going to. Even though this one could do both. It just takes a lot longer to do fertilization, because it also takes a long time to do lime. I'd like to get a better lime spreader. So yeah, we just got to sell some stuff. We got to sell... We've already sold all of our sunflower seed. We're just trying our best to get this converted into tomatoes for us. So tomatoes are still, or we have 500 liters per, so we got 1500 liters right here, and 1500 liters doesn't sell for very much. 1500 liters of tomatoes. Yeah, so for this is per thousand, so we'll make $1,500. You know, like, it's not gonna make us much. It'll be nice. It would be nice if we can get this done in a couple months and get there. We can start planting though, no matter what, with our new machine. See if it moves faster to do that in the spring, because we already are at that month where we probably could do that next month. So. No, in 2 months. So what we, and like I said before, there's some time we're gonna have to wait here, but we'll check back in with you guys in the next episode when this field has been planted, harvested potentially, and when we are at the stage of fully upgrading our machines. Because as soon as you guys see me upgrade machines, then we'll really do some time lapses when this field get done more quickly and regularly. All right, everybody, we appreciate you stopping by. Remember, this is Chuck Thunder. Be sure to like and subscribe. As always, this is Chuck Thunder, signing out.